Let me first of all say that we are trying to actually have a culture in the workplace where everybody, literally everybody, whether it be there women, men, transgender, everybody feels extremely comfortable to come and work. They feel safe and comfortable to come and work. They feel happy, safe and comfortable to come and work. And we're doing lots of things actually, starting with, you know, the time you start from home to come to the workplace, whether you can actually use a public transport, which is good. If the public transport is not good in the office, we are happy to even provide you with shuttle services, pick and drop services. We have flexi time. We recognize the fact that women particularly have more than one job. They have a job in the office and they have a bigger job at home. And to just make that easy, we are more and more, and now technology permits us as well, that people can be anywhere and still be able to contribute to the workplace and to work. Let me give an anecdotal example. One of my colleagues, I won't give her name right now, she's one of our better workers, and when she delivered a second child, we basically allowed her for almost a year to bring the baby to the workplace. Not to the creche, to the workplace. And we took turns looking after the child. We actually enjoyed. He was called the Prince of UNDP. I have lots of pictures with the Prince of UNDP. We are trying to improve the ratio of toilets of women and men, making sure that, you know, toilets are kept clean, because this is again something that we realize, and particularly in Dhaka. In Dhaka, the fact that, you know, you have such horrendous traffic, that, you know, women often get into fall ill if they don't, you know, are unable to go to the toilet. In the fact that they don't feel comfortable going to the toilet anywhere and they don't have the opportunity, they often end up not drinking enough water and get dehydrated. We actually celebrate equally anytime any colleague, women or men, actually achieve something special. In fact, we try to be a little more affirmative by actually celebrating when women actually make us proud. Because we recognize that in our societies, unfortunately, still, there's a lot of catch-up to do when it comes to women and men being treated equally. As far as UNDP is concerned, globally, I can proudly say this, that even in my ilk, people of my cadre, globally, we are 122 of us, and today there are almost 64 women and 58 men. And that's why this year we celebrated International Men's Day. So basically, there are lots of things which are trying to make women feel more comfortable. But most importantly, we want to lead by example. We cannot be asking others to do things if we don't practice it ourselves. And that's where I think we have a very strong mechanism where any kind of sexual harassment, anything that is even using the wrong language, for example, using gender insensitive language or behavior, is something which is considered zero tolerance. So we have a mechanism where people are constantly reminded that they must be conscious of sensitivities around them. And once you have become conscious of the sensitivities around them, and when you have people like me, who also have a extra burden to lead by example myself, and so that through our exemplary behavior, we are able to change the culture in the workplace, knowing fully well that if I can do, and let me look at what you have said here in this mug, in this little cup. It's a very smart idea, first of all, this cup. It says, Office Kimba Basha, Sarbroto Nari Nirapottai Pok Amader Puttasha, Akmatra Puttasha. Ami mone kori, and I very sincerely believe that if the workplace sets a standard where people spend the best hours of their day, any working day in the office, if they're treated with respect, they're more likely to practice the same or continue the same behavior at home. So women will expect better behavior from home, and men will behave better at home.